I would like to share some of the facts, sociocultural, including political and some our justice system in Nepal about controlling the recruitment, we can say bad recruitment agencies. First, I think I would like everyone here to understand the social cultural aspect of Nepal. I think not only in Nepal, but South Asia as a whole, the people like to talk more, the people like to mix with each other, the people like to be in touch with their family member. This is our socialization. So what I feel when they come here to work, they are completely isolated from their family, their society, their friends. So I think there is a minor things which we can do is to let them in communication with the family members, to let them in touch with their relatives, to let them in touch with their friends from the same country, from the same regions. That will automatically like us solve 50 to 60% problems. As you know that we have some mechanisms in Nepal, like we have Department of Foreign Employment, we have Foreign Employment Act, we have Labor Code, we have Civil Code, and we have Anti-Trafficking Acts. Despite those laws, we have some problem in implementation, in enforcement particularly, because we have very little registered recruitment agency, but the brokers, middlemen are large number. And they, particularly the workers, they are giving misinformation. Okay, you are getting high amount of salary, it's a heaven, like a dream. The title I saw, it's like a selling dream. But when they come here, they see completely different pictures. So I think that is, I think we can jointly, like a Lebanon and Nepal governments, and at the people level also, we can jointly control about the misinformation and recruitment. I would like to highlight, there is a double payment system. Like domestic workers who come here, they pay huge amount of money to the recruitment agency or middleman. Like most of them, they sell their property, their land, their house, and got the loan on 36% interest, which is high rate for them. But here in the report, I saw that the Lebanese, they also pay. So it's a double payment. So let's control this double payment system, which is the crux of the problem. The next things I would like to request is to double contract, dual contract actually. They are given one contract in Nepal, but when they come at the airport, they get another contract. So I think even for the employer, it's better to check the government registered contract, the original contract, because they have to promise something. If they get different things here, that could create problem in the works, in their psychology, different kinds of problem. Next thing is like a ban. The Nepal government has banned domestic workers. But the problem, rather than having positive impact of ban, we have negative impact of ban. Because then it creates extra burden for the domestic workers to pay more to the middleman, to come through illegal channel. So it's not effective anymore in our context. So yes, this is the lobby we need to do in our country. Ban is not effective anymore in our context. I would like to study, I visited some of the family, Lebanese family here, and I realized that now having domestic worker in home is related with class. If you have domestic worker, it's like a social status to have domestic workers. I realize that. But that particularly the middle class, economic family, they can't afford full-time labor, domestic worker in their home. So there is a gap in their income and having domestic worker. So what I would like to propose is to change the labor pattern, the work pattern, like in UK, in other countries. They have like a part-time labor. You don't need to have 24 hours in your home. You just need 3 hours. I asked even the domestic workers and employer both to know about each other culture and society. Sometimes you feel that, okay, domestic worker is misbehaving, but that's not misbehave. That's their orientation. That's the way they are living. That's the way they behave in their society. So it's also about understanding each other sociocultural practices. That is really important. Even my point is not orientation for the domestic worker, but also sociocultural information sharing with the employer. So they are well aware about the society, economy, their family. And last point, which is very important in my opinion, is to develop a prosecution, like a prosecution mechanism, particularly curbing the double payment of recruitment agency and dual contract. So let's cover that practices, and finally let's have staggered contract, at least minimum, with minimum understanding, minimum like living standard and minimum wage. These are the two things which we can include in the contract, and that should be the standard contract.